Are you nervous?
Yes.
Why are you nervous?
Because I feel like everybody hates me.
Why?
Because of the internet.
The Oscars are every actor's dream.
And I can't deny the fact that you like me.
A lifetime achievement that'll cement you within the upper echelon of talent.
What a room full of talented and inspirational people, and what the hell am I doing here?
For most people, it's a dream. Though for Jennifer Lawrence, it was closer to a nightmare.
Falling down when you're going for an Academy Award. I would imagine you just play that over and over again in your head.
At the young age of 22, she'd won the Academy Award for her role in Silver Linings Playbook, a film that would show the world just how talented she really was.
You're a hypocrite, you're a conformist, you're a liar.
Yet her shining moment would be derailed by a lack of coordination.
I would give anything to be able to go back and redo that moment.
To ease the embarrassment, the crowd would give a standing ovation, which she certainly wasn't buying.
You guys are just standing up because you feel bad that I fell, and that's really embarrassing, but thank you.
The problem with the fall is that it startled me, and it made me forget a speech. It made me forget to thank important people.
To make matters worse, there were even critics who suggested it was done on purpose.
Anderson Cooper was like, she obviously faked it.
But then something interesting happened. You'd assume that every tabloid in existence would plaster this in every checkout lane and article on the internet. Surely she'd be mocked relentlessly.
And it was so devastating because it was this horrific humiliation to me that like took away, like, I don't know if I'll ever have a chance to give a speech like that again.
But that wasn't the case here. Instead, people praised her. She tripped on her way to the biggest stage in all of film, and where some saw a mortifying experience, others saw an endearing authenticity.
The fall on the way up to the stage?
Was that on purpose? Absolutely.
Was it a fall? What happened?
What do you mean what happened? Look at my dress. What went through my mind when I fell down? A bad word that starts with F.
As social media grew, so did insight into the lives of celebrities.
Why are there so many pictures of Jennifer Lawrence showing the middle finger? 'Cause I'm an ass.
But there was now much less interest in perfection. They wanted reality.
I want to be the kind of person who will say that thing that's really hard to say, that's really awkward and really difficult.
Jennifer Lawrence brought a welcome deviation from the norm.
I say all sorts of awkward things.
I feel like nobody wants to hear me talk.
I want to hear.
And despite being horrified by the experience, her public appeal only grew. Then, just a year later, and at the same event, she'd do it again.
I heard you fell over earlier.
I did. I tripped on a cone.
And then the next year, everything would have been fine if I didn't fall on that damn traffic cone, because then it immediately looked like it was my
shit. That's what she does.
My heel snapped in England.
This would further stoke the flames of criticism. But after looking deeper into who she is, it really starts to seem like the clumsiness is kind of just her thing.
Between both of us, we've gotten more press over tripping and falling than anyone.
On the Hunger Games press tour, I fell in every damn city.
A PR team can do their best to portray an image. A makeup team can do their best to hide imperfections, but it's really hard to hide human nature.
But you actually seem like a human being.
Oh, thank
you. They're not perfect.
No. Where are you going with this? Once I enter a public place, I become incredibly rude.
Put the blockade.
Yeah, just be an asshole. Like, see somebody walking towards my table and just go, or like, can I have a selfie? And I'm like, no.
Especially one that isn't all that experienced within the limelight.
An older woman approached me and was being really, really nice. And in my head, I just went, this is Elizabeth Taylor, who was dead at the time, who's still dead. And so the whole time she's talking to me, I'm like, oh my God, this is Elizabeth Taylor. I was like, me? No, I mean you. Your movies that I can't name. And then my friend walked by and I grabbed her and I was like, this is Elizabeth Taylor. And she was like, no, it's not.
Jennifer Lawrence isn't the direct relative of a famous director, nor does she have a family deeply rooted within the industry. In fact, she grew up relatively poor and far away from the glitz and glam of Hollywood.
Growing up on a farm, you have ups and downs.
No access to the lights, cameras, or hair and makeup. But it's not just the clothes that make a person, it's often the scent. Celebrities especially have access to such a wide variety of fragrances that are either either inaccessible to the average person or simply too expensive. Personally, I've been super into colognes lately, so I jumped at the chance to work with Scentbird in sponsoring today's video. What I didn't realize though is just how massive their selection would be. We're talking hundreds of options and some of the most luxurious scents on the entire market. A lot of these fragrances retail for hundreds of dollars, but with Scentbird's monthly subscription, you can try a number of different options, all at a really affordable price. Now, when I received mine, I was shocked at just how large the vials were. This is a lot of fragrance for not a lot of money. My personal favorites were the Italian fragrance Tonstrina 17 by Pisterzi and Mancera from Cedra Boise in Paris. But it's not just Europe. We're talking luxury scents from all over the world. They also come in these cool protective packages that are portable with any bag. Whether you're out with friends or at the gym, it's super convenient to bring along. Each fragrance came with these descriptive cards that show both the ingredients and a brief description of the scent itself. However, if you want to do a more thorough approach, the website has a number of customer reviews for each product so you can easily find which one better suits your needs. And if you're interested in trying it for yourself, you can use my promo code Renzi to get 55% off your first month at Scentbird or scan the QR code on screen. That's just $8 for your first month and just $16.95 for a continued subscription. I'll leave more information in the description below, but once again, that's promo code Renzi or just use the QR code on screen. Thank you so much to Scentbird for sponsoring today's video. Now, when people think of Jennifer Lawrence, they automatically assume, surely this personality is faked, right?
You say what you're thinking. You are not calculated and edited. You don't censor yourself.
I don't really have a choice. If it was something I was doing on purpose, then when I got bit by it, I could just be like, oh, I'm not gonna do that anymore. So when it bites me in the ass, it just bites me in the ass.
Well, Jennifer Lawrence was raised rough and tough alongside her two older brothers. She was excessively hyper, even to the detriment of her own social appeal.
You had a nickname as a kid, and I don't understand it, Nitro.
Because I was unstoppably and uncontrollably hyper. I couldn't be stopped by medication or anything.
You know, I struggled as everybody does, you know, in elementary school. Where do I fit in? How do I make friends? And then, you know, eventually you're like, oh, I'm willing to jump out of the back of a bus to make people laugh. I guess that's my thing.
Well, I jumped out the back of a bus because everybody told me that I wouldn't. And I have a very disgusting, competitive, horrible disease.
Pair this with immense social anxiety and you've got the recipe for some serious emotional turmoil. What she needed was either an outlet or some proper direction. In time, she'd find it. While on vacation with family, she was spotted by a talent scout, who then arranged a number of meetings with various talent agents. What Jen would find out is that when performing, all of the stress and anxiety that came with social interaction would melt away.
The first thing I ever acted in was, life. I actually got myself out of being suspended by acting in the principal's office.
She could, for a brief few moments, completely immerse herself into a different person. The problem was, her parents were massively against it, and understandably so. She was only 14 at the time, and everyone's aware that Hollywood isn't exactly the healthiest place for a developing youth.
Hollywood, especially at your age, your young age, a lot of pressure on girls, a lot of pressure on young women.
However, she was dead set on her dreams, so much so that she'd prioritize acting over education.
I struggled through school. I never felt very smart, and when I'm reading this script, and I feel like I know exactly what it would look like if somebody felt that way, I didn't want to let it go. I dropped out of middle school.
Further raising alarms from her concerned parents.
This is what I was meant to do, and to get people to try to understand that when you're 14 years old and your parents are just like, you're out of your mind.
Yet, while their grievances were certainly valid, they'd realize she wasn't operating under an embellished perception of the industry. Despite being so young, it seemed she knew exactly what she signed up for.
You lived here when you were 14?
I did, yeah.
What was your apartment like?
Rat infested.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that the point at which mom and dad are like, yeah, no, she's serious about
this? When my parents came and saw the apartment, that was exactly what changed my dad's mind. There was like no hot water. My dad was like, she really wants to do this.
However, it would take a few years to get her career off the ground. After a number of indie projects, she'd land her first big blockbuster in X-Men First Class as Mystique. She was head to toe in all blue and barely highly recognizable, hardly a formula for mainstream success. Thankfully, just a year later would come a role most actors only ever dream of. With a following similar to the likes of the Harry Potter series and Twilight, The Hunger Games was a massive success, and at its helm was a 20-year-old Jennifer Lawrence.
How grateful are you to your mom for persuading you to take that role?
Oh, I'm so grateful.
Just 6 years into the industry and at the pinnacle of mainstream success.
I have to say, I've never regretted one day of it.
Though success doesn't necessarily correlate to fulfillment. She was certainly fit for the role of Katniss, but it hadn't fully tested her skills as an actor. What we didn't know at the time was that her range would be on full display with David O. Russell's adaptation of Silver Linings Playbook. This film was incredibly heartfelt.
Time after time after time, I do all this for other people. And then I wake up and I'm empty. I have nothing.
You love me?
Yeah, I do.
It was both a critical and commercial success. Not only was it on the radar of the general public, but the Academy Awards as well.
Jennifer Lawrence.
And so, we're brought back to this one major moment. The incident that caused the world to really fall in love with Jennifer Lawrence. But as the saying goes, fame is often a double-edged sword. And what on the surface seemed like a glamorous and fulfilling lifestyle would end up being the perfect environment for a turbulent nightmare.
I was angry and resentful for you because I thought that I deserved the right to do what I love and do my job and then still have privacy. But that's not the way it is.
You feel like a zoo animal or something.
See, Jen had rose to fame pretty quickly.
Is it happening too fast?
I mean, the main thing is the way people look at you and talk to you because you don't feel any different.
She didn't have the proper PR guidance you'd usually see with actors who had family already well-rooted within the industry. This tomboyish upbringing and the fact that she was raised alongside two older brothers made for a pretty blunt attitude.
Is Jennifer Lawrence
quitting Hollywood? I don't know if it'll be my choice. I think I'm more likely to be fired from Hollywood.
She was unfiltered and unpolished.
And then a director pulls me into his office and is like, I want you to, you know, gain some weight. And I was like, no problem. I'll get right on that.
Some people were quick to call this a PR stunt, but it seems like it's just how she was.
And you're making a lot of money. You are, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, good.
With how quickly she rose to fame, there was no time to adapt. No time to polish her conversation skills or learn the proper Hollywood etiquette.
What about people who knock on the toilet door?
It's locked, so I'm in here.
Do you ever say, it's locked, I'm in here?
Or no, I probably silent? Just say, f*** off.
I don't really have the ability to be different.
Celebrities often have painstakingly curated public personas. In a lot of cases, the industry needs them to be marketable to as wide of an audience as possible, without leaving anyone feeling alienated or off-put. But it seems like Jennifer Lawrence had no concern for this standard.
You shot your first sex scene.
Oh my God.
How much do you talk about it ahead of time?
Like, well, you don't. I mean, right. You can't. It's so uncomfortable. I'm not gonna be like, stop. What do you think? Like, you know, are you gonna hump me once? Are you gonna be on top?
She was unwilling to deviate from her natural self, even in the most glamorous of moments.
You had a Philly steak sandwich before the Oscars instead of the required salad.
I was like, I could get a salad. And he said, well, if you can get a salad, get a salad. And I said, I'm getting a Philly cheesesteak. I figured, I want a Philly cheesesteak, eat a Philly cheesesteak.
This would, of course, lead to even more attention, something she isn't really all that fond of. When you're famous, you're often pulled in every direction.
That's a huge theme of my life, is people feeling entitled to absolutely everything.
Either by people within the industry or those in the general public who compete for your attention. Over the years, we've seen a highlight reel of her life, the appearances on red carpets, talk shows, and on the big screen.
I have a really, really cool job.
What most people don't realize is that when you draw this much attention, it can often feel incredibly lonely.
Every job has a downside. I get lonely a lot.
I'm surrounded by people all the time, and then it can be so lonely when all of a sudden everybody goes.
When you're used to being surrounded by yes men or opportunists, it's hard to tell who's being real and who's harboring ill intentions. intentions.
I don't know what it is. It's something in somebody's eyes. It's like you're not connecting and making eye contact. Sometimes people are just...
Fame shines a huge light on that part of people.
This loneliness can often cause celebrities to spiral, creating a lapse of judgment and a lack of care for their own well-being. Now, thankfully, it seems as though she has a solid support system, but fame has still taken its toll.
Yeah, you seem like you don't let it bother you. That's pretty amazing.
You got to, otherwise I'd be in a foam room.
When describing her perfect day, all she really wants is some anonymity.
Well, if I could imagine it, I'd be able to wake up, and my alarm wouldn't go off, and I'd wake up really late. I could go on a walk, and I wouldn't wear a hat, and I wouldn't wear sunglasses, and I could walk and make eye contact with whoever I wanted and smile and get my own coffee.
She knows, however, at this point, that isn't possible.
But realistically, a good morning for me is, I order room service, and then I watch TV and eat in bed.
But the lack of privacy isn't just reserved for public appearances, it's also prevalent on the internet. That's arguably the scariest part of this whole thing. She was being exposed to constant scrutiny and ridicule.
Because the public is so fickle that you have to have tough skin. The way people feel changes all the time. See me get out of my car and they're like, God, I don't know why, but I just hate her.
Your self-image mocked in perpetuity, your privacy accessible to the masses. Pair this with exhaustive press tours and a lack of recently fulfilling roles.
And by the way, the women are always saving the men around here. You might want to think about changing the name to Ex-Women.
So I'd be like doing stuff and then I'd be like, isn't this gonna seem a little obvious? And then when I saw the movie, I was like, oh, right, spy movies.
And eventually, it all becomes too much. After the release of Dark Phoenix in 2019, she'd opt to take a break.
A lot of people talk about it and you actually did it. What did you do for the last 3 years?
I just had a ton of sex.
We all have fantasized perceptions of Hollywood and what it's like to be famous. However, for some people, this dream can often turn into an inescapable nightmare. Jennifer Lawrence came into the industry just wanting to act. She was incredibly serious about her craft, and it most certainly shows. Be it a widespread fan favorite in The Hunger Games, or the critically acclaimed all-star cast of American Hustle, there's an incredible talent here, one with the charm an organic approach to match.
I saw Francis Ford Coppola, but it actually was Francis Ford Coppola. Went on and then introduced myself to the whole table. Hi, I'm Jennifer Lawrence. They had no idea who I was. And went back to the table. My entire dress was unzipped and my thong was out.
It's rare we get to see this level of transparency from such a massive star. And given her recent return, we'll thankfully be seeing a lot more of it. Thank you so much to Scentbird for sponsoring today's video. Remember to use the promo code RENZI for 55% off your first month, and thank you again for watching.